All right. Yeah, this hand is high risk, high reward. I'm going to keep it. I'm on the play. It's a little bit better on the draw, maybe, but I mean, a turn two guy is just a lot better on the play, so. Just got to hit, right? The hand is helped along by the fact that even if I miss a land drop on turn two, I can still fire off the Rattle Chains. And at least, like, add to my board state. The hand is hindered by the fact that the Hierarch could just get bolted. And then I would have to hit twice. Okay, turn one to Coddle. So we're probably facing Burn here. Let's do this. Yeah, I like how turn one Nicottle is like now a sign of a burn deck as opposed to a zoo deck. You're like, oh, I'm probably facing that burn strategy. And that's why I ran out Selfless Spirit instead of Rattle Chains, of course. Or the path. Like, ideally, if we knew that the opponent wasn't going to kill our creature, it would be good to path the Nicottle. Let's upkeep path it. The opponent's at 14, so, like, if we could have played a turn two Geist, it would have been fairly strong. Ugh. Yeah, that's pretty okay. And now we lose. Alright. That was fun. That was fun. Sometimes you eat the bear, sometimes the bear, it eats you, right? All right. I believe in steals. This is one of those matchups where you cut images. You cut images pretty much anytime you're boarding cards in, except against Bant Eldrazi. Image is really, really good against Bant Eldrazi. So the images stay in if you're doing like no sideboarding, which comes up against like Scapeshift. And then they just like serve the role as filler cards. Yeah. I think that's right. I could shave another Rattle Chains. Rattle Chains and Selfless Spirit actually trade with like Goblin Guide though, so they're not the absolute worst. Let's run this. This hand is good. This hand's like real good. One drop, two drop, three drop, go. And we're not taking much damage from our own mana base, unless we like want to shock ourselves to hold up the Blessed Alliance. This is a little strange. Oh, cool. We can fetch a basic now. I'm actually just going to go Cavern on Spirit. They're bolting my Wanderer. Alright. Looks like we're going to see a Searing Blaze here. I think that would be the line where Bolted Wanderer makes the most sense. Eidolon, sure. Yeah, no. No, I'm gonna take that too. Bolt is targeting the captain. Pretty sure I sack the spirit here. The spirit's only a 2x attacker anyway. Interesting. I kind of just want to play this to gain 4 life and like not even eat the Eidolon. Super interesting. Let's see what happens when I attack with this Drog Skull Captain. More bolts. Yeesh. They definitely shouldn't have let me untap because if I could have drawn the for one, I could like play a land and have company. There's also Spell Queller, and then you've also seen the Hexproof Giver as well. Okay. So it doesn't look like we're gonna end up locking our opponent out of their own Eidolon. But we still have a good one here. Company is our best draw for sure. Let's grab Island question mark. Choose target player. Choose target opponent. And Eidolon does trigger even though I paid 2 for Escalate, because Escalate doesn't change the casting cost of the card. Okay, so we get Skullcracked here, which is gnarly, because now I'm not gaining the life or whatever. But they do lose 2 more for the Skullcrack. And now we're in a place where we kind of need to draw like a company or a... This is okay. Let's run this back and be kind of glad I was using Cavern there. Would like to hold up path. Say no here. No, I kind of need this path to be good. Yes, perfect. Upkeep Boros Charm makes sense. Play around a top deck Spell Queller, I guess. I have no reason to run out the Temple Garden, so I'm not going to. With plenty of mana to cast everything we might draw. Alright, no, they can't fetch, but I don't think that matters very much. It's gonna be burn spell, untap burn spell. If they draw a creature or a land, though, those are the bricks. Like, obviously, they can't draw, like, an Eidolon of the Great Revel. Yep. Looking like Spell Queller was a card that I needed to draw at some point. Oh well. So it goes. Burn is usually like a pretty even matchup. So even though we lost here, for example, I did beat it twice in the Modern Open. And usually, like, I face it, obviously I face it a lot on Magic Online. It's pretty much a toss-up. You can win game one, which is pretty nice. Your game one's very winnable. And then it's not like Blessed Alliance and Rocks War Monk are bad. I think War Monk's a little bit better. Sometimes they do bring in Path to Exile, but usually they have to use Path on, like, a Drugskull Captain or something at some point. And then Rocks War Monk, if it goes unanswered, it's just like the bee's knees. So that's a little bit better of a hoser than Blessed Alliance, but the Alliance is so good against Infect that I'm still happy with that card for now. All right, on to the next round. Oh, Steel of the Godhead is a new one as well. Steel of the Godhead is also something that can steal game ones and game twos and so on.